Today's question, the MLS, the Supporters Shield, who's still in the hunt? We're going to do some great Monte Carlo analysis in Excel. All right, so this is the morning of September 23rd, 2023. Today's matches have not been played yet. Cincinnati has been the runaway favorite for the Supporters Shield since, June or July, right? They were like 15 points ahead. Whoever has the most points at the end of the season wins the Shield. But Cincinnati had a pretty tough month so far in September, winless in September, and a lot of teams are closing the gap, right? So just doing, like, if Cincinnati would lose out, get no more points, who could get more than 59? It looks like Orlando City, Columbus, Philadelphia, New England. To me, it looks like Atlanta is out. Nashville is in the Western Conference. St. Louis is in. LA has a chance to get one more point, and Houston has a chance to get a tie, but then it looks like they would probably lose on goal differential, but we don't know. So they're still in, right? So here are the teams that are still left, matches left, 47 to the third power. That's only 103,000 iterations. That's easy, right? All right, first thing. It's actually not 47 matches left. It's 39 matches left because let's say that Philly plays New England. The 47 includes that game in both of their schedules, but then eliminating the ones where they play each other. We're down to 39 matches left. So here's the dates. Home team, away team. Right now, I'm using a ran between here with three possible outcomes. One, the home team wins and gets 3 points. Two, the away team wins and gets 3 points, or it's a draw and they get 1 point each. So here you see it's a draw, 1 point to Cincinnati, 1 point to Charlotte. Let's do a test here. Nashville or San Jose is the home team. They would get 3 points. Nashville gets zero. And the last one here, New England is the home team. Two, the away team wins. That would be Charlotte gets the 3 points. So there is a little model of just one way that the rest of the season could go. Every time we press F9, it's going to recalculate those random numbers in Excel. We come down here to collect all of the home team points gained and all of the away team points gained. That is a function in Excel. This is a great new function that just came along last year in 2022 called VSTACK. It stands for vertical stack. We're going to stack these two arrays on top of each other into a single array, which is beautiful. And then here's the nine teams left. How many points they gain, that is going to be a sum if. So it looks through all of the remaining games. How many points did they pick up in each one? And then their points now, and then final points. So in this one iteration of the rest of the season, the max number of points would be 60, and that would be a tie between Philly and Cincinnati. The model does not go into the tiebreakers, right? We're just trying to figure out how many times you're going to be at least tied for the first time. All right. So when I started this, it was like 4:30 in the morning, and I made a critical math error when I said there were 39 matches left. 39 to the third is 59,319, and I actually built all 59,319 options, but it was really weird. The numbers weren't coming out at all, and then I realized it's not 39 to the third. It's equal 3 to the 39th, like that, which is just an insanely large number. More rows than I have in Excel, and not something that I can calculate unless I had a crazy supercomputer. So it's impossible to do all of these. What is this? This is millions, billions, trillions, quadrillions, like four quintillion ways that the season could play out. All right. So when I run into this and I don't have enough computing power to run all of the options, what I love to do is I love to run the season some large number, like let's say 100,000 times, and Excel is amazing at this. All right, this is one of the more amazing things that Excel can do. We have a huge model there with 421 formulas to get this result of Cincinnati winning on this iteration. Every time we type a number in and press enter, it recalculates and Cincinnati won again. But when I want to run that 100,000 times, so right here, I put in the numbers 1 to 100,000 using the sequence function. And right here, I put in a formula that pulls the result of the 421 formulas. Right? So that's the top of our data table. We select this whole range and go to what if analysis, data table, and specify for the column input cell, anything, any blank cell, like A1 or it doesn't really matter, just anything. And because this is random numbers in here, it'll run 100,000 times. So right here, you see the first six times Cincinnati came out on top, and then Orlando City came out. Rather than having to look through the 100,000 rows, I have a unique function here to get all of the possible finishers for the supporter shield, and then a countif function to figure out what percentage of the time. Took these two arrays here and H-stacked them. We used VSTACK before, H-stack, and then sort. So in this particular iteration, Cincinnati wins the supporter shield outright, 97% of the 100,000 runs of the season. There's then another 1.3% where there's going to be a tie with Orlando City, and they'll probably win on goal differential. But hey, Orlando City fans, 1.3% of the time of these 100,000 models of the rest of the season, Orlando City overtakes Cincinnati and wins the supporter shield. There's instances where Philly and Cincinnati tie, Philly wins outright, Cincinnati New England tie, Cincinnati St. Louis tie, you know, and some really interesting things. I think New England and Philly play on decision day. Wouldn't that be fascinating to have a tie going into that and have that game be the deciding factor? So, you know, while Cincinnati has had an amazing season and really is likely to win that shield, there are other teams that are still in the hunt. And even if your team is not appearing here, we could run this another 100,000 times and have a different set of results. I currently have this set up here on the Formulas tab. Calculation options is that brand new partial option, which calculates everything but the data table. So I could now calculate the sheet. It'll take a while because, again, it's doing 421 formulas times 100,000 simulations. All right, but there you go. We have similar numbers, 96.7% Cincinnati, 1.3% chance for Orlando City, 0.3% chance for Philly, some chance of just New England winning it outright, and a lot of tiebreakers. Well, hey, good luck to all the teams. If you're still in the hunt, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel. If you like these videos, please down below like, subscribe, and ring the bell. Feel free to post any questions or comments down in the comments below.